cowboy's a man with guts and voice. A cowgirl is strong will and independent. Have a tilt of your Stetson for ones who love the freedom of a wide open range. You with the dusty jeans, dirty boots, and rough hands. Turn off the radio, let the tailgate down. It's a Western life, and for me, it's all I need.
Howdy, y'all, and welcome back to High Noon. Now it's the spooky month of October. Today I'll be reading you a couple of old Western ghost stories. Our first story is the death ship of the Platte River, Wyoming. On the Platte River between Torrington and Alcova, Wyoming, a legend persists that a ship of death continues to sail upon the sometimes dangerous waters. The phantom ship rises out of the strange mist that quickly becomes a massive rolling ball of fog. As the ship grows closer, witnesses report that its sails and masts are covered with frost. The crew, also covered with frost, stands upon its deck and huddles around a corpse lying on a canvas sheet. The legend continues that the ship always foreshadows the death of someone who will die. On the day it is spotted, as the crew steps back, the corpse identity is revealed as a person known by the witness. The first alleged sighting was made in 1862 by a trapper named Leon Weber. When the crew stepped back, the corpse revealed the body of Weber's fiancée, who died later that same day. Another sighting of the phantom ship was made by a cattleman, Gene Wilson, in 1887 when he saw his wife's body laid out on the canvas. In 1903, another tale describes that he spied the ship when Victor Habe was chopping down a tree on his riverfront property. Laid out on the deck was the body of his close friend. Every case was reported in the late fall, and in all cases, the person seen upon the deck of the phantom ship died on that very same day. One of the sightings allegedly occurred 6 miles southeast of the town of Guernsey, Wyoming. Another sighting was said to have occurred at the Bessemer Bend on the Platte River. Well, that was bone-chilling. Now on to our next story. The Buffalo Ranch Haunting in Colorado by Jason Hamala. Read in his perspective. I grew up at the Guernsey Buffalo Ranch just west of Denver, Colorado. My father is still the ranch caretaker and lives in the two-story house built by the Patrick family. In the 1860s, headed west from Missouri, the Patricks and their five boys built the house and operated a stage stop on Guernsey Mountain. When we moved into the house, the former caretaker lived in a house trailer in the backyard. His wife would not set foot in the main house because she saw strange things and said the house was haunted. When I was about 12, I remember a night when my mother was upstairs screaming hysterically as our dog loudly at the wall. My dad and I ran upstairs to see what the commotion was all about. When we arrived, she related that she had seen a floating, glowing green ball go down the hall and disappear through the wall. I slept with the covers over my head for the next several weeks. The next haunting came about 6 months later, a night that still feels as if it happened yesterday. As I was sleeping, my father woke me up and asked me if I could hear music in the house. Barely, I could make out the faint sound of a fiddle or violin. Dad had already checked all the radios. They were not turned on. We searched for the music source and went downstairs, where you hear the music coming from the upper story. The vice versa, when we went outside, we could still hear the music coming from the house. We continued to hear the haunting music a couple more times that same year. A few years later, we received a book from a local historian describing the complete history of the house and the Patrick family. Information that was unknown to us until we read the book. The first murder in Jefferson County happened in our front yard in the 1870s when one of the Patrick brothers shot and killed another brother in a dispute over a dog. The brother he killed was known to be very lazy, and the only thing he liked to do was sit around and play his fiddle. When I read this and remembered the fiddle music during those nights, a cold electric sweat ran through my body. We also found out that The boy's father is buried somewhere in the yard, but there is no marker. The house had been peaceful now for several years, and hopefully the Patricks are now at peace. I still get a chill when I hear fiddle music. Updated November 2021. About the author, Jason Hamala loved the Old West and spending time relic hunting and bottle digging. He also liked early military and outlaw history, and most recently, he has become involved in Western reenactments. Well, that was a little spooky, but seemed to have a happy ending. I'll be back after the break.
Do you have trouble going to sleep? Well, try Bedtime Coffee, the only coffee that helps you go to sleep. How do we do it? We do it with our special Bedtime Coffee beans. Don't believe us? Well, here's our intern Steven's thoughts about it.
This is just NyQuil you put in a coffee maker. Aw, Steven, that joker.
Mr.
Aw, crumb.
Oh, stop, I didn't do anything illegal.
And we're back. If you're wondering why the audio quality of the ad is so much different than because I made that little skit like 3 years ago. And before we go, I just want to leave you with Ghost Riders in the Sky by Johnny Cash.
An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny, and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky. For he saw the riders coming hard, and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi-yo! Faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught 'em yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. As the rider floated on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. They are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-yi-yo!
Wish all of you a good high noon.